Okay, everyone, and welcome to React Knowledgeable. So today we will be my sharing about the techniques that we can apply to improve the web page with lazy loading images. So in my sharing today, I will divide into four sections. The first one, I will discuss a bit about the overview of why do we need the lazy loading image. And the second part, I will discuss about more technical techniques that we can apply to achieve that. In the third section, I will discuss more about the UX thing. How can we use this technique with a smooth UX and better UX? And finally, I will mention a bit about the future native support of lazy loading image. So to start off, these are some statistics that I collected just yesterday from the HTTP Archive website. So it shows some overview about the size of the web page nowadays. So as we can see that for the mobile page, right, the size is around 1.7 megabyte and nearly 40% or 50% of it is the image asset. Which is a good thing because the image make our website more beautiful, and for like pages like e-commerce, we actually need nice images to attract the customers. But it means that if we don't manage the resources of the image correctly, and it can affect the performance a lot. So why do we need lazy image? The first one is that for better performance, because in a website, the most important factor is we care about is the size of the page. The smaller the size, the faster user can download and see it. So, and the point here is that not everything is visible to user on the first time they load the page. So actually, then we can lazy load them without affecting the whole experience. And the second advantage of lazy loading image is the cost reduction. So for example, nowadays most people are surfing the web that in mobile with the 3G or 4G connection, and if the image is not necessary to visit to view, there's no need to load them to save the data per user. So then in a web page, which images that can be lazy loaded? So here is that all the content visible to user on the first render cannot be lazy loaded. It is the full, right? It's like a new newspaper, like you have a very long newspaper, and only the viewport of your screen is the content above the full, and only this content is visible to user on the first time they load the page. The rest, it can be lazy loaded later without affecting the core features of the website. So our concern is how can we delay the rendering of the images below the fold to save the bandwidth for other resources. So how can we really implement this in technical terms? There will be two steps. The first one, we need to find a way to prevent the image to be downloaded by the browser. This can be done using the HTML image tag, or we can also use the CSS background image. And later, the second thing we need to do is we need to detect if that image is in a viewport or not, and then we download it and render it in the browser. This can also be done through the JS JavaScript events, or use the new Intersection Observer API, which I will discuss in detail later. So if we want to start with the image tab, so for the browser, whenever it see an image HTML tag, it will download the image immediately if it sees the source URL. So to prevent the download of that image, we need to remove that source URL from the image. So a common way is we just use the data source attributes to set the image source, and later on when the image is actually in the viewport, then we read the attribute data source and set the image source to this one. And for the CSS background image, what we can do is we actually just put the image as a background image in the CSS style and don't apply that class to the HTML. And later on, when we do the same thing, if we trigger it, if the image is in a viewport, we just toggle the class name. So the browser will see the class name, apply the CSS rule, and it see there's a URL and download the image. So how can we detect if an element is actually in a viewport or not? So to achieve this, we mostly rely with pure JavaScript, we mostly rely on the getBounding client React API. Basically, this API will return you the top left, bottom, and right position of an element corresponding to the viewport. So, and the big one is here, you see here is the viewport. So the problem now is just reduced to the a very common problem in algorithm is that you have two rectangles. You have coordinates of two rectangles. You need to define whether the two rectangles are overlapping or not. So after that, right, you can just listen to some JavaScript events to your document like scroll or resize, and continuously check for the lazy image. So let's see the demo here. So this is the page without lazy loading. When I just enter the page, all the images are downloaded at one time, and which is not good because as we see here, I only see three images. Why I need to download like 10, 12, very long list. So I can achieve this with the event listener. So the code, I can show you the code. So actually we just need to listen to some events, browse or scroll or resize, and perform the regular checking when there is on scroll or on resize is happening. So this is the lazy load implementation using the JS on scroll event. So when I first load it, it only load the four first images. And when I scroll down, it will slowly render and download the rest. However, with this method, you have to continuously listen to browser event, which is may affect the performance a lot. So that's what. That's why we come up with a new API supported by browser now. It is the Intersection Observer API. So it is supported by most of the modern browser right now, like Chrome, Safari, Firefox. And we do only do the same thing. Also do the same thing. We just create here. I create a Intersection Observer. It's just basically an observer. I declare the viewport. The default viewport will be the viewport of your screen, and I pass in a callback to say, hey, what I do if I my entries is inside the viewport. As we do here is I just get the image and set the image source and unobserve that image from the intersection observer, so that the next time it will not be registered again. And this is the implementation. So the same thing is happening, and when we scroll, or then the image is a viewport, then the image is downloaded. Okay, so actually I have gone through the some basic technical technique that we can apply to lazy load the image. However, it has some side effects. The issue with lazy image is that when user first to see the image, they will not see it correctly. So let's say if the network is very slow now, I throttle it. User just see a white box when it's scrolled down, which is not good. So to overcome these things, we can what we can do to achieve better UX with lazy image. The first technique is we should use the correct placeholder before the image is shown. We should show them something. I just choose a nice placeholder to show them. Secondly, we also might need to add some buffer time to load the image. It means that we can preload the image before it is in the viewport, if it's near the viewport enough. Thirdly, which is important, is we need to avoid the content shifting. So I will discuss these techniques in detail now. The first one is for the placeholder. The easiest way is to use the dominant color as a placeholder. So this one we need the API support. It just process every image and provide a URL of a very small image with a dominant color. So this technique is used a lot by Pinterest and Google image search to improve their UX. So I have the demo here. So when I scroll down, I will see a different background image as a placeholder, and this one actually can have a lot and give the user the feeling that something is not happening, something happening. So the next one we can use is also popular, is to use a low quality image placeholder. So initially user will see a very small image and with a blur effect. And later on when the real image, the high quality image is ready, we just do the transition from the low quality image to the high quality image. This technique is widely used in Facebook and Medium. For Facebook, is the Facebook engineer team come up with a very interesting idea, is that instead of give the low image quality by URL, they process it to very small, 200 bytes maximum, and they encode it and put it into the API response to return to user. So this is one example that I get a photo from the Facebook engineering blog to explain how it really works. So we can also achieve this. Here is a demo with the blur effect. So at the beginning, I can expect here to see that user will see something very small quality. And later on, when you scroll down, it will trigger the download of the high quality image and give user the impression, I can know that this image, the shape of the image, the color of this image. So another technique is that we need to add a buffer time to load the image. It happens when if user scroll too fast. Then, for example, here, if I scroll very fast and I don't see the image fast enough, and which is bad, so we can improve this by preload the image. So, for example, so I extend the viewport a bit, like 5500 pixel more at the bottom. So in the list now, actually we only see 4 images, but I preload the 5th one. Just when user scroll down, they will see it heavenly smoothly. Another way to do this is we need to avoid the content shifting. So let me explain this a bit. So this is what I mean by content shifting. When we don't have the image, right, we should show something. If I just give the size incorrectly, then later on when the real image come in, then the content will jump, and which is effect, which is quite bad. So, and if the network is really slow, this can be troublesome. So to avoid that, we need to provide a correct size, or at least some placeholder with the same size with the real image, so that when the image is really downloaded, then when it kicks in, the layout is still there, and we can send lots of can create a nicer UX. Okay, the next one is what we actually do in Shopee is we actually defer the render of the image until it's really ready. So what happens if the image is really big and the internet is not fast enough? When user go to the page, they will see an image that renders slowly from top to down, which is not good for us in this case, because if they have lots of images and all the images are rendered partially like this, then it will become janky. So the technique that we do to solve this problem is we use the new image API, the image decode. So basically, this is how it starts. When the image is entered the viewport, we will not set the image source immediately to trigger the download. We will set the image source to trigger the download, but we don't show the image yet. We actually wait after the image to be downloaded and to be decoded. And until after it is decoded, then when we render the actual image. So this can be achieved with the new image API. It's the image.decode. It will return a promise. We just wait for the promise. When this promise is completed, then it means that the browser has fully decoded this image and is ready to show to render on the DOM. So applying this technique with the same thing, those are very big images, and we actually defer until the image is fully downloaded and decoded. So even if the network is slow or the image is big enough, user will either see a placeholder or a full image. It's not partially rendered anymore. So I haven't gone through some techniques that we can apply to achieve better UX with lazy image. But the good news is that recently there are plans that we will have the native support for lazy image natively in browser. It will be available in Chrome 75, shipping in upcoming months. So in the future, what we can do is when you declare an image, you can add more attributes, the loading attribute. It can receive three variables, three values, either it's lazy, just tell the browser that we would like to lazy load these things. Can be eager. Eager is just tell browser that this image is important. Just download it right away. And auto, and we just let the browser to decide is eager or lazy. So currently we can try it in Chrome Canary with the, but we need to enable the flag for lazy image. This is the things that we may do in the future. We detect if the loading is supported by the browser or not. Then we just use the loading attributes. Otherwise, we just do the party view or do the techniques I mentioned previously to achieve the lazy load. But it's not that simple. So here, this is the Chrome Canary latest version, and I enable the lazy image loading flag, and this is my page again, and I don't do anything except just render a simple long list of images with the loading is lazy. So let's see how it works. Actually, it's not lazy. So maybe it's not ready yet. It's a bit weird because this year at the Google I/O, I saw the demo and it worked very smoothly in the browser. But assume that it works correctly, we still have some issues here. Because the image, even if you declare the image is lazy, it's not fully lazy. The browser will try to download right the first 2 or 3 kilobytes of that image to know what is the size, and they render something partially. As we see here, only 4 images are visible in the viewport, but they only download the first 2.4 kilobytes. And somehow they download error on other images. Because let's say for an e-commerce website, if we have lots of images and the browser will download 2 kilobytes of each images, it's still a lot. It's still a lot. So even if we can have in the future, we can have this native support, we also need to come up with our own customization to achieve better performance. So that's it. Thanks a lot for listening to my talk.